Where am I? And why am I here? Dantino, a curious, intelligent child like many are, finds himself lost in the middle of a frightening dark wood. But he does not waste time wondering why. He must get out of there fast. And that is where his great adventure begins. Together with Virgil, a dear friend of his, he sets out to leave the dark wood. But the only way out is through a deep abyss. Hell. There, our two little heroes will have to cross scary, desolate places. They will run into monsters who will try to trick them and block them from pursuing the right way. They will have extraordinary encounters. Their courage will lead them to the scariest of all places, the very bottom of the abyss. But they will make it through that too, and eventually they will come out under the star-filled sky once again. One, Dantino in the Dark Wood. It was a beautiful spring day, and Dantino, a child with big, bright eyes, was sitting on the grass near his home. As he stared at the light blue sky, he began to daydream and fell asleep. When he woke up, somehow he found himself in a scary dark wood. It was so frightening. He immediately started to look for a way out of that terrible place. He walked and he walked until he saw faint light, so he went towards it until he realized that he had reached the edge of the dark wood. There, in front of him, was a small sunlit mountain. He decided to climb that small mountain, which seemed so much nicer than that terrible dark wood. But suddenly, a ferocious-looking leopard with multicolored spots jumped in front of him. An instant later, a lion appeared next to it, and then a skinny, hungry she-wolf, who looked like she wanted to devour him. Terrified, he began to step back when, out of nowhere, someone appeared in the distance. It was another boy, a little bit older than he was. His name was Virgil. There were friends, and Dantino adored him. Virgil, who knew this place very well, explained to him that the hungry she-wolf would not let anyone get by. "I know which path to take, so we don't have to go back into the forest," he said. "If you want, we can go on this crazy adventurous journey, you and I." Dantino agreed, and so behind him he kept. Two. The Gates of Frightening Words and the Guardian, Charon. They had only gone a short while when they came across an ugly, half-rickety gate. On it, these frightening, terrible words were written: "Abandon all hope, ye who enter here." This meant that whoever crossed it would never come back. But the two children had to pass through to continue on their journey. So they did. Thank you. they found themselves in a very dark place. Hell. There, they only heard terrible sighs and cries. Although the light was faint, Dantino could see monsters stung by swarms of wasps and hornets that were running in a zigzag, following a banner. The banner kept changing direction with all the monsters chasing behind it, in the middle of mud filled with horrible worms and maggots. Just beyond them, dark shades appeared. They were shouting terrifying words as they neared the banks of a great river named Acheron. A bearded old man, all white with blood-stained eyes, was pushing the shades onto his boat, hitting them with the oar to make them cross the river. "That's Charon," said Virgil. Then suddenly there was a huge earthquake. Wind and lightning shook the place. Dantino was so scared that he almost fainted.